was 7, Trisha met a man named Philip, who later became Shawn's stepdad. She started going to church with her son. Shawn became involved in a church team called Team Jesus, doing dramas, karate, and taekwondo. When he was young, he got into skating, and he was even featured on in a couple of magazines. His mom says that he was interested in singular sports a lot more than the ones involving being a part of a team. So I was listening to this podcast called Thin Air. I will leave the link in the resources below in the description box. But it was really interesting. Interview was talking to Trisha, she was kind of talking about who Shawn was, and I feel like the background that she gave was just it was perfect for the theory of what happened to him. But anyways, I'm just getting ahead of myself here. So she says that around 7th or 8th grade, he started to change, and he even mentioned that he had to mimic other people's behavior to know how to, behave in social situations in order to be liked or normal like other people. So at 17, Shawn moved to San Francisco with his longtime girlfriend. Her name was Anjali Troll, so he could pursue music because he wanted to do music for a living. He played keyboards for a local band that was performing gigs around the Bay Area. However, since his disappearance, they seem to have broken up, and their social media accounts like Twitter, MySpace, and Facebook were deactivated or dead since 2011, so since the year that he went missing. On one occasion, when he went home to visit his mom and stepdad, he told them that he thought he was autistic and that he had Asperger's, but he was never officially diagnosed. And the 5 years between leaving home his disappearance, Shawn went to school at San Francisco State University, and he was saving up money to eventually move to New York with his girlfriend. So because they were trying to save money, they shared an apartment with 5 other people, which is a lot. I mean, 5 more roommates. So his mom said on the podcast that he had changed his Facebook picture, and in the new picture he was holding a suitcase and seemed to be running like he was running away from his life. She asked him about it, but she never said what his response was, and the next day the picture was gone. He changed his name on Facebook to Klaus Agnes, a combo of his 2 favorite bands. So it was also around the time that he reportedly started exhibiting the sort of behavior that wasn't really typical Shawn. For example, he was caught stealing a dress jacket from an upscale clothing store. He had an upcoming court date scheduled for December 7th, 2011. And another thing to mention that is definitely relevant is that he lost his wallet and ID shortly before he disappeared. And that resulted in, him having to use cash since. His mother... You guys, I'm really sorry if this video has a bunch of cutouts. My cat is being impossible tonight. So, his mother... And the boss didn't really want to let him leave early because it was a small store and they were short-staffed anyways. But eventually the boss agreed to it and Shawn left, and then he almost immediately came back to the store saying that he forgot that he didn't have his ID with him, and so he asked the boss to accompany him to the bank so he could cash out. So they went to the bank together, he got the money, and then they parted ways, and the boss was under the impression that, you know, Shawn would go to lunch and then return and finish the rest of his shift, but he never saw him again. He tried contacting him several times, but to no avail. So finally, around 11:30 p.m., Shawn responded via text and apologized for not returning to work. His boss replied, warning him that he could be fired if he was not a reliable employee. Later that night, around 1:14 a.m., a neighbor reported that he had a few minutes conversation with Shawn on the shared balcony, and that he seemed very frustrated when he told him he lost his job at Rolo's. After talking to the neighbor, he got home to his girlfriend, Anjali, and made no mention of the day's events. His girlfriend had some friends over, and she said that Shawn was acting very weird and annoying, like an embarrassing little brother. He stayed up really late, long after she had already gotten into bed. The next morning, she woke up thinking he was late for work. The next morning, she woke him up thinking that he's late for work. He got dressed and left without telling her otherwise. However, he never went to Rolo's that day, nor did he ever contact his family or friends again. He was last seen wearing light gray zip hooded sweater, black dress shirt, black trousers, and brown dress shoes. Instead of going to work, he went on a walk around town, posting several random photos of his private to his private Facebook page, and after that, he seemingly vanished into thin air. So, assuming that he indeed was the one to upload these pictures to his Facebook page, it appears that he was still in San Francisco around 4 p.m. that day. However, his family and friends noted that it was very out of character for him to post anything, let alone several pictures. His friends had gotten used to him not returning home for days and sleeping outside the house, so they waited until court day, and when he failed to show up, then his girlfriend contacted Shawn's mom, asking if he was there. Even though Trisha only learned about his disappearance 8 or 9 days later, his friends officially reported him missing 6 days later when he failed to show up for court. His mom claims that police did nothing but tell his friends to fill out the missing persons form and didn't even contact her to let her know her son was missing or ask if he was with her. Trish also mentioned that he already paid for tickets to spend time with them on Christmas that year, so that's really weird. Eventually, the family managed to pressure police into getting his phone records. One of the calls he made was to a local bicycle renting So, another woman whose 15-year-old son went missing decided to attend a rainbow family gathering in Norwood, Colorado. Trisha asked her to take Shawn's picture with her just in case, and the woman said that she saw him there. So, Trisha contacted Norwood police immediately and sent them Shawn's picture. Trisha and Philip then made the 7-hour trek from Denver to Norwood. There weren't many people there, and they weren't able to find Shawn. When she returned home, however, she had a message from the sheriff that she had previously sent the picture to. He said he wanted to talk to her more about her son, that there had been multiple sightings of him in the past day or two, and that he's got some info about where he's headed next. Several rainbow boys were arrested for breaking into stores, and when asked individually if they knew Shawn, they said that they knew him and that his name was Trip. They also said that they know he's a missing person because he told them. It is unknown why Shawn never showed up for his shift, but considering that he'd been reprimanded by his boss the previous day, it's possible that he assumed he would be fired if he showed up late again the next morning, so he just decided not to go at all. But yeah, the question remains, what happened to him? Where is he? So, one potential theory is that he was upset over the possibility of losing his job, so it could be that, and that maybe that somehow had something to do with his disappearance. According to his page on Charlie Project, his loved ones say that they do not believe him losing his job would have, you know, upset him like this much. Still, his girlfriend believes that it is possible that he might have died by suicide. Another theory is foul play, but if so, you know, it is unknown by who. Or like, you know, why would anyone harm him? Was he a victim of a robbery, a random attacker? We don't know. Yeah, so